Okay guys, it's Sunday, August 25th, and I think this is my fourth SkyWalker flight. Yesterday I went 8K, or 5 miles, and today I'm not really sure what I'm going to do. I'm going to go out there, and if it's looking good, I'll do 10K, which is about 6.5 miles, but I'm just going to take off and fly and see where it takes me. It's in auto circle mode. It's gonna maintain 71. Okay, I'm sitting down now. I'm putting my goggles on. Let's hope my plane doesn't crash. Last thing I want. Okay, goggles on. Colors look alright. I can read everything. Vibrant. Out of auto circle mode, we're going to look for a heading of 350 is our heading. Ours to size is good. Sun is setting, but that's alright. Heading is just about right. We'll come over a little. Okay. Trim is a little off. Trying out a few new features. 1K away, return to home. It's gonna climb a little. Oh, it's this way. Our heading. Okay, remember, roll right. I need it to roll right more. Pitch up could just be a hair. Just a smidgen. Here we can look at Jandal's property. I'm just going to do a nice climb and get pretty high up. So I'm not going to go very far out. Maybe 4 or 5K. Okay, full control. Video's a little off, that's why I'm just doing circles, just trying to see where it likes to be. Right here on my heading seems okay. 5K away. Notice my RSSI is still plenty. Become 8 kilometers. I want to burn no more than 1800 milliamps and I know I'm okay.
my video is a little bad. Just to return to home. That works alright. My video's not too happy right now. I'll check that out when we get back and cooking my antennas off. It should be good at 350. But if I go this way, I think it gets worse. I'm 8K. I'm gonna go 8.5 just to make a new record. On that heading, just trying to maintain it. Anything else seems to look alright? 8.5 away. RCSI is great. Let's go 9. There's plenty of power. You know, it could just be the end of the range of this patch. Okay, 9K. I wanted to do 10, but video's not getting any better. This way, nor this way. Oh, it's alright in the middle. At a heading of 050. I'll do 10 if I can, but if my video goes bad. Plenty of power in the pack. We're going to try and do 10. That's what I planned for today. Maybe we got to get up a little higher. We're going to climb. Come back to our heading. And we did 10K. Alright, hooray. We're going to turn back to the right. 10,000 meters. Very cool. Do a nice gentle bank. Our video should get more clear. Since we have the V on here and it's facing home. Return to home mode. I'm gonna hand fly it now. Come back this way. My video is not so great out here, is it? We're off course. Definitely have a noticeable headwind. I'm sorry, we have plenty of altitude. Okay, so right now it's in return home. I'm gonna try and readjust the patch.
See if I can get any more clear video. There we go. Now I'm flying through the monitor. 8.5 away, am I? My video is now very crystal clear. And we definitely have enough power to make it home. It scared me a little. I looked and I had 15 volts on my pack. I guess that's because I was pulling like 20 amps at one point. So when it was under load, it was a little low. But I have no doubt that we'll make it back. I have crystal clear video, no worries. I'm actually about to check my phone. Give me a sec. Oh, I got a text message. Only pulling 3 amps. I'm just going to follow that line. Still plenty high. I'm going to ease back on my power. I really don't need to. It's nice to carry just a little so I don't stall it out. I know I shouldn't do this, but I'm texting and flying. Not a good idea, huh? I just want to see what happens when I let go of the sticks. It's flying alright, even at 4 amps. I'm totally off the sticks here. It's maintaining heading, it's doing everything perfectly. Wings level, it's nice. I'm gonna... Heading's a little off, we'll come back. Ease up on my power just a bit more. I'm gonna go back to about 200, there we go, 18, 19. Just about there looks alright. We are getting pretty low, pretty far out. So I can keep my power in there now that I think about it. I'll stay around here. 6 amps is good. We'll maintain altitude. I don't want to climb, don't really want to descend. But these Philips monitors are working absolutely great. I'm flying through it right now as we speak. I think my plane could definitely use a nice trim. We'll see, I'm gonna set her level. Looks like it needs some extra right yaw, because it's going to the left. So I just put a few clicks of trim on that, and still problems. There we go. Okay, that's back to good. And let's test the roll. The roll, could use one or two to the left. Okay, there we go, a little left roll. Check it out again. We'll give it one more to the left, and a few more right from the yaw and rudder. And then the pitch seems to be absolutely perfect. Could probably even use one down, because we are doing a little bit of a climb at just 6 amps. But I am 7.3 out. I'm on my way home. So my new record is 10K. Pretty cool. Chainlink did an absolutely perfect job. It's an original Chainlink. I have a diamond antenna and a low-pass filter on it because I'm flying 1280. But made it 10K, didn't kick in the failsafe, no glitches, absolutely nothing. You see I have absolutely perfect control. Perfect a Chainlink. If you look at the top right corner, you can see my RSSI. I'm going to make my antenna vertical. It's not very bad. Now it's horizontal. and I was facing the plane. I'm gonna turn around facing the opposite way, and it dropped, but still didn't kick into failsafe at all. So, okay. Now I just gotta get it home. Flying pretty long, about 27 minutes. 7:27, sunset's very, very soon. So I'm gonna grab my glasses really quick. Sorry, I totally pointed the antenna the opposite way. We're coming home. There's a lot more wind than I would really imagine. I do not see the plane at all. Sorry, this flight isn't much of a narrated FPV flight. I'm just talking, just not much technical stuff here. I'm just. It's a nice Sunday cruise. I'm flying around. 6.5 out. Pulling 4 amps. Tell me to go this way a little, which that's about right. I should really be flying a heading of 160 to get directly home. But I must have blew off course. Okay, you can see we're barely descending, just a hair. Just below the artificial horizon. And as soon as I can find a cloudy day, guys, I'm definitely going to come out here and try and get on top of the clouds and just a new experience with FPV. Made it 10K out, so it's a nice benchmark I have there. My RSSI jumped back up. It's definitely noticing that I'm close by. But just a hair of power. Actually, we're alright. We can just descend at this rate. I think we'll make it. Here's at 4 amps. Our pack still has 15.2 volts, just around there. So it's probably around 3.85 per cell, or a little less. Yeah, because 15 volts would be 3.75 per cell. So my batteries are definitely good. This is on a 4-cell 5000 still, so I really don't need to run two of them in parallel, which is a good thing. I'm gonna go right over this lake. Let's just hope my plane doesn't die. Check it out. We'll get a little altitude and then I'll point down at the lake so we can see it. Okay. I think this is called Todd's Pond. Not really sure. It's a nice pond. You can see the cars. You know, put in return to home and just mess with my antenna really quick. Vibrating a little. Wonder what it's doing there. I'm gonna take it out. That was really odd. I guess Charles is gonna have to look at that. This is a MyFlyDream autopilot system. Although what you just saw didn't look so great, other than that, everything else is perfect. I really have had no complaints. The return to home saved me. About a week ago, I was 2.7 out in a new flying location, and I totally lost video signal and UHF signal, which is very odd, but luckily return to home worked, and I got it back. Okay, this is definitely a long flight. Longer than I anticipated. I just have a hair of a headwind on my way home. There really isn't any wind where I'm standing. It's totally dead. But I just want to get this thing back before it gets dark and I have trouble seeing it when I land. I'm still 5 kilometers away. I'm going to cruise around 8 amps, try and get home a little quicker. But what I'd really like to do is stretch it out as far as I can to see the minimum amount of battery it takes me to get that far out and back, so I know kind of what kind of range to expect. Okay. You know, we actually climbed a little, so I'll come back and I'll just descend, try and pick up some speed that way. Doing about 30, which is, looks alright. Everything is perfect, we're making it home more than fast enough. You're really picking up the pace. Here's a nice golf course. I'll go this way a little, and then there's some type of bug totally flying around me. It's weird. It's doing a circle around my head. So we're going to pick this back up to about 6, 7-ish. And we'll check out this golf course. I want to come back here during the daytime when it's sunny and get a nice clip of this. There's our local turkey farm. You can see all the white buildings. Again, guys, I'm up in Pennsylvania, so let's not lose that heading. What's funny is my antenna, it gets good signal totally the opposite way. Right now, my plane is flying in from the left of my position. So right where that arrow is where I am, and my antenna is pointed to the right from where I'm standing. But somehow it's getting great reception, so I don't really have any reason to change it, but I just find that kind of funny. Alright guys, the sun is totally almost down, and I really just want to bring this thing in. We're going to descend. Now we're doing 34, we're definitely coming home quickly. Bug on my screen. 35, now my speed's starting to pick up. I'm gonna come down. Yard 4 out. Coming home. Here's my heading of 180. That looks about right. Trying to pick up some speed. Oh, now I see where I am. This is my local high school. Right here to the left. You see the track. That's neat. Okay, so I'm not too far away now. So my position should be about right... right around, I think somewhere up on one of these hills. Right around there. Right there, I think is me. We'll see. Looks like I'm getting some vibrations at this high of a speed. I'm pulling 11 amps. I'm doing 40 kilometers. Maybe my motor's vibrating. Why don't you guys let me know? It's just a little off. Maybe I can get some rubber washers to stick in between the motor and the plane, and we'll see what I'm doing. We're definitely getting closer. I'm gonna power back. Oh, I was doing 12 amps. Okay, power back to cruise around 3 or 4, maybe 5, and just pitch down. So we're well within range to come down to about 150 meters. Now I just gotta find home. Yeah, this flight was much longer than I thought. That's alright, I had fun. Question is, where am I? We'll see. Oh, this is a park right here. My center thing is on a baseball field. So I am right here. That's me. Right a little to the right of my dot is right where I'm standing, around right in this grass strip. it's hard to point. Right there. Okay. That's cool. Two out. They're coming. Again, my speed is definitely slow. I just pulled my amps up a little. A little quicker, and it's definitely working. The last thing I want to do is land at night, because I have bad eyes as it is. I can't land in the day half the time. Okay, so this brought me home. My new record is 10 kilometers out. Hopefully I'll go 12, maybe 14, 16 one day. I'll just keep pushing. We'll see how far this chain link will go. But so far, guys, it's an amazing system for really around $100 or $120 to get 8-10 miles out. That's not bad at all. And you can see I've got crystal clear video most of the time. I'm running 1280, and I'm sure it'll get even more clear if I ran 1258. So we're gonna ease back on our power and totally try and come right in. So I am standing actually to the left of where I showed you, right there. That's me. Right there. Pretty sure. Let me double check before I get so sure about it. Yeah. Yep. Okay, here's the farm. Right here. That's the farm. And there's like dirt bike trails through there. Again, I'm right over here. Now I'm looking for the plane. Should be out here somewhere. I don't see it yet. I'm going to try and keep this altitude. Right here is good. Huh. Maybe my motor's loose or something. That's odd. Okay, I still don't see it, but I'm definitely close. There it comes down. Come over this way. Okay, I just got it. I now have it within line of sight. Keep coming down. And this house I'm flying at is an absolutely beautiful house. It's gorgeous. And I'm standing right there. There's my car parked in the center. I'm just gonna fly line of sight, and now I gotta land before it gets too dark to see it.
Alright guys, that was a great
Alright guys, so that's it. It's my first successful 10 kilometer flight out, and hopefully I can do a lot further in the near future, hopefully this week. We'll see how the weather is. But just comment, rate, and definitely subscribe for more. Thanks for watching, guys.